So octopuses use its arm to explore.
When people have wondered about this for a while, how they are using those arms to do this, how they're finding things in the seafloor.
Octopuses feel their way to a tasty meal. But for a long time, researchers have believed there is more than touch going on.
Touch taste sense is a term. It combines elements of mechanical sensitivity and also chemical sensitivity.
Now researchers think they're uncovering the molecular mechanism behind this proposed chemo-tactile sense.
How does this apparent chemo-tactile sense work? What are the cells? What are the molecules? And how does the animal use them to interact with its world?
And their work is opening a new window into how sensory systems evolve and how those systems impact behavior.
Octopuses are excellent model systems to understand how molecular evolution affects the sensory systems of animals.
Octopuses experience the world very differently from humans.
Certainly there are some things that are familiar. We know that octopus are visual animals and they'll use their eyes. But what's really striking about them is the way they use those sort of enigmatic eight arms that they have, and they're using those to really reach into cracks in the seafloor to probe around to surfaces or areas that aren't accessible to things like their eyes that maybe they can't see into.
Octopuses appear to be able to accept or reject potential prey using only their arms. And it was this behavior that led researchers to investigate their sensory capabilities.
There were some very early studies from the 1960s that showed what looked like sensory cells in the epithelium of the sucker cups. And that was one of the things that got us curious in the first place, that, yeah, it seems like maybe there's a bona fide sensory system housed within the arms and the sucker cups, but we don't know anything about how it works.
But the publication of the first octopus genome in 2015 has led to new studies, including research into gene expression profiles in different parts of the octopus.
The rationale here is that the sensory receptors we're looking for should be more abundant in the rims of the sucker cups versus other places in the octopus. And what was really striking to us was that instead of, you know, a single receptor or a couple of receptors, we identified an entire family of these chemotactile receptors.
But the receptors they identified, which they call chemotactile receptors, or CRs, didn't look like the kind of receptors usually seen in sensory systems.
They didn't resemble known sensory receptors, and instead they're most closely related to a family of receptors called nicotinic acetylcholine receptors.
Nicotinic acetylcholine receptors are found throughout the nervous system of many different animals, but usually they detect neurotransmitters within the body and are involved with things like controlling muscle contractions. In humans, they're the focus of research into treatments for everything from Parkinson's disease to nicotine addiction. But they are not sensory receptors, or so researchers thought.
In the course of their evolution, octopus have converted these ancestral nicotinic acetylcholine receptors into sensory receptors. They look almost identical at first glance. And it wasn't until we looked closer that we started to appreciate some of the structural regions that are mediating these functional differences.
The team imaged the octopus receptors using cryo-electron microscopy and compared the structure they found with the nicotinic receptors found commonly in other animals. And they found a subtle but very important difference in an area called the ligand binding site. This is where the receptor binds with its chemical partner. In nicotinic receptors, this is a cage-like structure that binds with neurotransmitters like acetylcholine, causing its ion channel to open and transmit signals. But the octopus receptors are different. Instead of a cage, they've evolved to have a shallow groove, and that allows for a wider range of materials to bind, in particular materials that don't mix well with water, like the kinds of greasy residues left on the seafloor by potential prey, a useful tool in a hunt.
We describe this as being a chemo-tactile sense, which basically combines chemo-sensation, sensation of chemicals, with tactile sensation or touch.
This clarified picture of the molecular mechanism behind taste by touch helps explain some of the octopus's unique behaviours, especially when compared to the structures of the same types of receptor in related animals like squid.
Octopuses use their chemo-tactile receptors for their exploratory predation behavior. Interestingly, octopus and squid have a different predatory strategy. Instead of using its arm for exploration, rather, squid and bush predator hide, strike, and pull their potential prey, and then decide to eat or reject it.
This behavioral difference, the researchers say, can be explained by their different receptors. For example, the octopus receptors wouldn't work in the open water.
The types of chemicals that they're actually able to sense are very hydrophobic molecules, things that you would not expect to find in the water column in a marine environment, and things that instead you would expect to find on the surfaces in a marine environment. So it makes sense that they would have to physically touch them.
On the contrary, the squid chemo-tactile receptor binding site is not responding to greasy molecules. Instead, it responds to bitter tastings that are soluble and easily diffusive in water. It explains squid's strikingly different predatory behavior.
Evolutionary differences at a molecular level align with strikingly different abilities and behaviors. And this is far from the end of the story.
Oh yeah, there are a lot of things we don't understand. Here we just started to look at one of each receptor from octopus and squid. There are more octopus and squid chemotactile receptors with different properties, may pursue different function in sensory system.
For example, there is evidence that some octopus receptors can also detect voltage. But how this ability fits into their broader sensory system is still unknown. Even within the world of the chemotactile receptors already studied, there's much more to learn.
You know, we initially got into this study thinking that we would be studying a sensory system that's used for predation, for finding prey. And while we still think that's the case, so far most of what we've discovered relates to aversive stimuli or things that the octopus doesn't like. And so we're really interested to find if somewhere in this diversity of CRs, there are receptors that mediate what we would call appetitive sensation or, you know, food, things that the octopus maybe wants to eat. Or if the octopus maybe just eats anything unless it has a signal that says, no, don't eat this.
Researchers are gradually building a better comprehension of how sensory systems evolve and being able to combine behavioral observation with complex structural understanding gives scientists yet another piece in the evolutionary puzzle.
The cephalopod, including nautilus and cuttlefish, they evolved differently from octopus and squid. So that'd be very interesting to see how and why they are different from molecular atomic level to animal behavior level.